pleasant. I could go on like this forever. No school, no work. Just this. He patted Phyllis. And this, Yash. Phyllis was looking at Johnny. Tell us about Bermuda. Another time, Chip. I'm no public speaker. Johnny fell asleep. He woke to find the cool wind playing over the beach and the sun of a fall far down on the horizon. Anne had fallen asleep on his chest. He put his arms around her and rolled her off and over onto her back. He kissed her soft throat enough to her ear until she shivered and opened her eyes. He started around the beach. They were alone. Anne said, Elva had to go home. They'll all be back later to go swimming. This is like being married, he whispered against the pulse beat in her throat. On our honeymoon, you know. I'd like being married to you, Johnny. You know what I'd make you do if we were? What? I'd make you take your bathing suit off so I could look at you. She writhed against him, kissing his cheeks and lips and throat with nibbling lips. I will if you want, Johnny. I'll take it off for you. You want me to? I'll do it, he murmured, kissing her shoulder. The suit straps came down and the bodice peeled away so that the round white breasts were right under his eyes, rigid nipples thrusting upward. He bent and kissed her while the guest and shook in the turbulence of her emotions, holding his head in her arms and rubbing her breasts against his face. We shouldn't be doing this, she panted, but I don't care about anything except myself anymore. You know that, Johnny. Not even about my father, and I love him so much, so much. He went away and left me with my mother and hate her. He realized she was saying words but not understanding what she was saying. It gave him a good feeling to listen to her, to know the convulsive movements of her hands and hips, stripping off the black peak so that she lay naked on the blanket and let his eyes go over her all the time she went on talking. A flush came into her cheeks as she felt his hand reach out and stroke her. Her tongue touched her lips and she whispered, "Me too, Johnny. You know what will happen. I don't care," she whispered. Then his trunks were on the sand and they were together, clinging and shuddering and knowing the wild, careless rapture of the flesh. She cried out again, again in a broken voice as if she were in pain, but held him all the tighter. Afterward, they carried their swimsuits into the water to wash the sand out of them. They dressed and pulled their suits on underwater, then waded to shore where Anne busied herself setting out fried chicken on cardboard plates. They ate with their backs propped against each other, feeling faintly sad and lost. I'm not a bad girl, Johnny, Anne said suddenly. Who said you were? Look, I know what you boys think about us girls when we let you. Pushovers is the word. Round heels. Look, Johnny began, turning so he could see her face. There were tears in her eyes. There's no need to say anything. I just wanted you to know I'm not as common as you might guess, the way I've been with you today. I just felt in the dumps. It was a way of striking back at my own father. My father was to come see me, Anne whispered, running fingers through the sand. We were going out together for Sunday dinner. He never came. She put her face in her hands and began to weep terribly, shoulders shaking. I was never so disappointed. I cried all night long. His arm went around her and he pulled her in against him. Oh, don't cry, Anne. They aren't worth it. None of them are worth it. All they think about is themselves. All the time. Just themselves. She tried to giggle through her sobs. We can be like that, too.